when I came into the field a few decades ago. In those days, there were a few quants, and you know, the eggheads had to try to figure out how to fit in with the MBAs, right? But now there's a variety of roles, and people are becoming embedded in so many different companies, so many different parts of companies, you know, whereas it used to only be, say, the trading floor. Now it's risk management, but now it's also in corporate treasury, as well as, you know, many other analytical parts of the company. So no matter what you think about cryptocurrency, whether you think it's a real asset or you think it's a bubble, the fact of the matter is that the underlying technology, which is blockchain, is here to stay, and is going to find applications well beyond, already has found, frankly, applications well beyond cryptocurrencies. So I think it behooves us as an organization, and I'm very proud, actually, of Elisa and the faculty for having, you know, designed and implemented that course, that we can teach state-of-the-art technology and market issues to our students, right? And be open-minded about it and not say, oh, crypto's bad. It might be, but that doesn't mean we shouldn't understand it.